George Zimmerman may be a free man tonight, but his life may never be normal again. Neither will the lives of Trayvon Martin's family members and his supporters. So tonight, we have in-depth coverage on what's next for both sides 24 hours after the not guilty verdict and the sweeping reaction all across the country. Let's start with Zimmerman's immediate future. His attorney tells ABC News that he is entitled to get back the gun that he used to shoot 17-year-old Martin. Mark O'Meara, his attorney, says that while Zimmerman is free to do whatever he wants, threats against him will make that nearly impossible. In fact, it'll probably be tough for him to find work again.
Unfortunately, even though he did nothing wrong but protect his own life that night, the way that things were sort of visited upon him by the way the case was handled initially made him a pariah, even though it shouldn't have.
All across the country today, thousands of Trayvon Martin supporters took to the streets. They're outraged over the verdict, and they're worried about what kind of precedent it sets. There was also a vigil tonight in Minneapolis. It just wrapped up, and 5 Eyewitness News reporter Naomi Peskovitz was there. She joins us now live from the newsroom. Naomi?
Leah, tonight's vigil was in memory of Trayvon Martin. More than 100 people were there, unhappy about the verdict. But it was much different than rallies we've seen around the country. There was song, prayer, and more than anything, hope for peace.
We shall overcome.
In a South Minneapolis synagogue, candles burned for victims of gun violence.
Oh, deep in my heart.
Shir Tikva's Rabbi Michael Latz acknowledged tempers may be burning too.
But we know, we who have gathered here tonight, what happens when we act out of our anger and our rage and our hostility, when we break and we smash things.
So on this night, Rabbi Latz asked the crowd to shake hands. The reason for this vigil is a verdict.
Not guilty.
The outcome, he hopes, something larger.
In moments like these, it's so easy for despair to pervade. And at some level, this is a challenge to that despair to say, no, we've got to keep going. And to do right by this young man's memory is to build a world in which this doesn't happen again.
Rabbi Latz was not shocked by the verdict.
Doesn't constitute a crime.
And neither was Minnesota criminal defense attorney Joe Friedberg.
People should mourn, but they should not mourn how the legal system worked, because I believe the legal system worked the way it should have worked.
Though Zimmerman is now free, Trayvon Martin's family could sue in civil court. And the Department of Justice says it will look into possible civil rights charges. Friedberg says that's not likely.
I think a civil suit would be ridiculous, would be carrying this too far. I also would be extremely surprised if the Attorney General moved forward with a federal civil rights claim.
And we also spoke to attorneys today about the Stand Your Ground law, which allows someone to defend his or herself with force. In Florida, you don't have to try to retreat from the situation. According to Minnesota law, you do. Lawmakers passed a Stand Your Ground provision last year, but it was vetoed by Governor Dayton. Reporting live from the newsroom, Naomi Peskovitz, 5 Eyewitness News.
And today, President Obama is urging people to react peacefully, whether they agree with the verdict or not. In a statement, he called Trayvon Martin's death a tragedy for America. He also issued this challenge. We should ask ourselves if we're doing all we can to stem the tide of gun violence that claims too many lives across this country on a daily basis. We should ask ourselves as individuals and as a society, how can we prevent future tragedies like this? And on social media, so far Twitter users have posted more than 4.5 million tweets related to the Zimmerman verdict. Several hashtags include Justice for Trayvon, Million Hoodies, and We Are All Trayvon. Those are still trending tonight. NFL players Ronnie White and Victor Cruz apologized for tweets that they posted after the verdict. White said that the jurors should go home and kill themselves, while Cruz wrote, quote, Zimmerman doesn't last a year until the hood catches up to him. Vikings running back Adrian Peterson tweeted a much more civil response, writing, my heart goes out to the Martin family. Keep the faith. God is in control. He is the one and only judge. And one question that still has no answer tonight, will we hear from any of the 6 jurors and the reason behind their not guilty verdict? Well, the judge sealed the jurors' identities at the start of the trial, meaning the media cannot try to identify them. Well, that court order is still in effect now. And at this point, it's up to each individual juror to decide if they want to be interviewed by the media. All 6 jurors were women, and analysts say it's unlikely we're going to hear from them anytime soon. Well,